Friends, I again welcome you to the channel, to my channel. Now, in the previous clip, video clip, we had seen how to design bolts and nuts or studs. Now, we will go up to the permanent fasteners, that is design of riveted joints. Design of riveted joints. You know, these are permanent fasteners. Once you join two plates, two machine parts by means of rivets or riveting, now they cannot be disassembled without damaging either the plates or the rivets, and the same elements cannot be once again reassembled. So they are called as permanent fasteners. So in riveted joints, they are first broadly classified into two types. One is lap joint and the other is butt joint. Now let us say these are the two plates which are to be joined. Now, if I keep one over this other and make holes here by either punching or drilling, pass rivets, hold the rivet here and form another head here. So, like that, if I use, then it is called as a lap joint. If it is a butt joint, the two plates will be placed like this side by side. Then, in that case, you have to use a cover plate. You have to use a cover plate, either one, or you have to use two cover plates, one at the bottom, one at the top you have to place, and then place the rivets. Riveting is to be done. So in butt joint, again they are classified further into single strap or single cover plate, single strap or single cover plate butt joint, and double strap or double cover strap, double strap butt joint. So they are classified into two. Here further, these are classified into single riveted lap joint, double riveted lap joint, triple riveted, etc. Similarly, here also we have single riveted, double riveted, triple riveted. Here also you can have single riveted, double riveted, triple riveted, etc. Now, for us, for you, your syllabus very clearly says design of single or double riveted. Here also single riveted, double riveted, single riveted, double riveted. In double riveted, you can have either chain riveting or zigzag riveting. Here also chain or zigzag. Here also chain or zigzag. You don't have triple riveted lap joint. Your syllabus is very clear that only single riveted and double riveted lap joint, single riveted, double riveted, single strap butt joint, single riveted, double riveted, or double riveted, double strap butt joint. This arrangement, if it is double riveted, it can be chain or zigzag. Now, what is meant by single riveted? See, if it is a lap joint, if the load is less, see, the load on this will be acting like this. The load will be trying to break this joint. We have made this joint like this. It is trying to break it. Now, single riveted butt joint means there is one row of rivets. You have used one row of rivets. This is called as the lap. How much one plate is lapping over the other, that depends upon what is the number of this thing. You make holes here and put rivets, and riveting is done. It is single riveted. Suppose the load is heavier, greater load is there, then it may not be able to withstand that. So it will be made, this lap will be made slightly larger. And here, instead of one row, we use two rows, then it becomes double riveted. If you further increase the lap and make three rows of rivets, then it is called as triple riveted, like that. Usually there are single riveted, double riveted and triple riveted joints, but for EVO, the syllabus very clearly says either single riveted or double riveted only. So we will stick on to that. Now, if it is single strap butt joint, the two plates will be held like this. One cover plate will be there on the top of this. Single riveted butt joint means one row of rivet here, one row of rivet here. One row of rivet here, one row of rivet here. Double riveted means this width of the cover plate will be greater. Two rows this side, two rows this side. Triple riveted means three rows this side, three rows this side. If it is double strap butt joint, there will be two straps, one at the top, one at the bottom, of both of same width. So if it is single riveted, double strap butt joint, one row this side, one row this side. If it is double riveted, two rows here, two rows here. If it is triple riveted, three rows this side, three rows that side. That is how it will come. So this, the joint will be again subjected to like this. Now a riveted joint can break in three ways. One of the ways is it can fail due to tearing of plate. There are three ways in which the riveted joint can fail. One way is due to tearing of plate. Tearing of plate. Second one is shearing of rivet. Third one is crushing of rivets. Now, tearing of rivet means here we have one row of rivets. Here we have one row of rivets. It can have any number of this thing. This distance is called as one pitch length. That is, center of rivet to the center of next rivet in the same row is called as the rivet pitch. Now, here it is the weakest, the plate is weakest after we drill hole, it is weakest. Here the plate can tear, it can get torn, you know, like cloth gets torn. So like that, this can tear. Now this length is P minus D. P is the pitch, D is the dia of the rivet hole. So half rivet here, half rivet here, this is the half D, this D is the dia of the rivet. So what will happen, there will be half D here, half D here. So here this can go. Now the load which the joint can take without this happening is called as tearing strength per pitch length, in one pitch length, per pitch length. Will be, this is called as the tearing strength per pitch length. That means the maximum load which the joint can take without such fracture taking place, that is called as tearing strength per pitch length. Similarly, shearing means the rivets pass through the plates. In some, they pass through two plates. In lap joint and single strap butt joint, each rivet passes through two plates and it is subjected to single shear. That means it can break at one section. It has to break at one section only. If it is double strap butt joint, the plate, every rivet passes through three plates. Top cover plate, main plate, and then the bottom cover plate. And it has to break at two places, so it is subjected to double shear. Now the minimum load which the rivet can, the joint can take without that happening per pitch length is called as shearing strength of the joint. Shearing strength, this is also per pitch length. Per pitch length. Now the failure can take place due to crushing of rivet inside the plate. Now the maximum load which the joint can take without such this thing is called as crushing strength per pitch length. Crushing strength per pitch length. Now this is designated by PT, this is designated by PS, and this is designated by PC. Now this tearing strength for a riveted joint, this will be equal to P minus D into TFT, T into rho T. That is, this is the length, I had marked there P minus D into thickness of the plate, that much is the area to be broken into permissible tensile stress, this is called as tearing strength. This is called NDT rho C, compression stress, permissible compression stress or crushing stress. N means number of rivets per pitch length. N will be 1 if it is single riveted. Any single riveted joint, N will be 1. If it is double riveted joint, number of rivets per pitch length will be 2. If it is triple riveted joint, N will be 3. That is, number of rivets per pitch length will be 3 rivets will be there. D is the dia of the rivet, T is the thickness of plate, and this is the permissible compression stress. So that gives you the crushing strength of the joint. Then shearing strength, there are two. If it is this PS will be equal to N pi D square by 4 into tau, that is permissible shear stress. Tau, this will give you, N is again number of rivets per pitch length, N will be 1 if it is single riveted joint, N will be 2 if it is double riveted joint, N will be 3 if it is triple riveted joint. You get only single or double, so N will be 1 or 2. Now if it is, this is the formula in case of lap joints, any lap joint and single strap, single cover plate, single strap butt joint, right, single strap butt joint, it will be the each rivet will pass through only two plates, so therefore it will be that much. PS will be equal to N into, it should be 1.8, it should be 2 theoretically, but practically we take it as 1.875 pi d square by 4 into tau in case of double riveted, double strap butt joint. Theoretically this should be 2 because it has to break at two places, but practically we take it as 1.875 into that, or this can be placed that side also. All these formulae are available in the design data handbook, you need not remember them. So these are the formulae. Now this is what we mean by the strength of the joint. There are three strengths: tearing strength, shearing strength, and crushing strength. That means this is the maximum load the joint can take without tearing happening per pitch length. This is the maximum load which the joint can take per pitch length without the rivets breaking in shear. This is the maximum load which the joint can take without per pitch length, without the rivets getting crushed inside the plates or the failure taking place. So these are the three ways in which a joint can fail, and these are the three strengths. Now coming to the design procedure here. Now, normally, what we have to find out is, first thing that we have to find out is B, if it is not given in the problem. Some, if it is given in the problem, then you need not find out. This is dia of rivet. Dia of rivet. If T, that is thickness of plates to be joined, are greater than or equal to 8 mm, then D is calculated using the formula 6 root T. Unwin's, Professor Unwin's formula, D is equal to 6 root T. You will get the answer in mm if you substitute T here, thickness of the plate, in millimeters. Then, if T is less than 8 mm, 8 millimeter, then D is calculated by equating the shear strength, that is PS, and equating PS and PC. If you equate these two, you will get the diameter of the rivet. Right. Normally, we don't get this case. We generally get the case where we are using D is equal to 6 root T. Second thing we have to find out is rivet pitch. If it is not given, if it is given, no problem. Rivet pitch. Now, this rivet pitch, P is calculated by equating, PT is equated to PS, tearing strength is equated to shearing strength, and we find out this. Then we have to find out row pitch, that is distance between one row and the other row. This will come only if it is, this is called back pitch, PB or PC they say. If there are two rows of rivets, this is called rivet pitch. Rivet pitch. This is called row pitch or back pitch it is called. Now this distance between one row of rivets and the other row is called as the back pitch. And this depends upon whether we are using chain riveting. Chain riveting means these rivets will be placed adjacent to each other. Then the distance between them should be little bigger. If it is zigzag riveting, then the rivets will not come here, they will come in the middle here. The pitch remaining the same in this. Here they can be little closer. It will be usually 0.6p or something like that. That will be, that you have to find out. Then margin will be 1.5d. Margin means the minimum distance from the center of the rivet to the edge of the plate, that is called as margin. That will be 1.5d. Then you have to find out efficiency of the joint. This efficiency of the joint means it will not be 100%, it will be always less than 100% efficiency. When will it be 100%? When there is no joint. If there is no joint, if it is a single plate, then it will be 100% efficient. When there is a joint there, it cannot be 100% or more than 100%, it will be less than 100%. This is given by least of or the lowest of PT, PS or PC divided by strength of solid plate. Strength of solid plate, that is plate before we drill, we make the holes. Strength of solid plate per pitch length, this will be least of PT, PS or PC divided by strength of solid plate will be pitch into T, thickness of plate into tensile stress, permissible tensile stress. These formulae are not important to you because these formulae will be already there in the design data handbook, you have to just pick up the right formula and substitute and get the answers. So they are not very important. We'll take up a problem from the question bank. I am taking the first problem in riveted joint, problem number one. It goes like this: a double riveted lap joint. Double riveted lap joint means N is 2. Single riveted means N is 1. First you note down that. N is 2. Lap joint with zigzag riveting. With zigzag riveting is to be designed for 13 millimeter plates. That means it is T is 13 mm. It's a lap joint. That also you must make a note. It's a lap joint. Lap joint, 13 mm thick plates. Assume permissible tensile stress is 80 MPa, 80 MPa, tau, that is permissible shear stress, is 60 MPa, 60 MPa, compression or crushing stress is 120 MPa, state how the joint will fail and find the efficiency of the joint. Find the efficiency of the joint. So you have to find the efficiency of the joint and tell how the joint is going to fail. Now, it's a lap joint. Now, that means this is one plate. I am drawing the front view. This is another plate. Another plate. There are two rows of rivets. Two rows of rivets. There are two rows of rivets. The arrangement is zigzag. That means one rivet will be visible and other will not be visible. One will be dotted, one will be visible. So this is rivet head. This is rivet head. Rivet head. Now this is hatched because this is sectional view. Sectional front view. This is another plate. Now, this is the front view. Top view will come like this. This is how the rivets are. It is zigzag riveting. I have taken this section here. Now, this one. This is how it is. Now this is called the pitch. This is the top view. This is pitch. This is dia of rivet. This is back pitch or row pitch. This is called the margin here. This is the margin here. That will be 1.5D. This is the thickness of the plates. So this is how the drawing will come. I have given this for you to understand this. That is, two plates are placed like this. So you are seeing from the front, you are seeing the thickness of one plate, thickness of the other plate. The rivets are passing here. So rows are there. So if you see from the top, you will get this plate, you will get this plate, and you will get something like this, a figure like this. Okay. Now, the first thing that we have to find out is the dia of the rivet. Dia of the rivet is to be found out. So, because the rivet, the thickness of plate is greater than 8 mm, that is 13 mm is the rivet, the thickness of the plate. So, we will use this formula, D is equal to 6 root T mm. 6 root T mm. This is there in the D is diameter of rivet, D is equal to 6 root T. So T is 13 mm. Substitute here. Take your calculator. Root of 13. Root of square root of 13 equals 3 point something into 6. That will give me the dia of rivet as 21.63 mm I am getting. Now, go to the standard size. The standard sizes of rivets are given here. Standard diameters of rivets are given. No, it is not given. So what you do, you take it as, say, round it up as 22 mm. Always on the positive side in design. When we are finding the dimension, it must be rounded up always on the positive side. Minimum you have to take is 22. You can even take 23 or 24. In some design data handbook, they have given the this thing standard diameter. So next standard diameter after this size you have to take as the this thing. So minimum, if it is not given, standard sizes are not given, you have to take it as 22 mm. So that finishes the dia of the rivet. Next, I have to find out pitch. For finding pitch, what I have to do is, second thing that I have to do is PT is equal to PS. Tearing strength is equal to shearing strength. Tearing strength will be P minus D into T into tensile stress. Here it will be N into pi D square by 4 into tau. Into tau. Permissible. This thing you will not get 1.875 because it is lap joint. This formula is also there. Here if it is in single shear, N into pi by 4 D square into tau. This formula is there. This is P minus D into T into FT. That is also there. Tensile the tearing strength. So, P minus D will be equal to N into pi D square into tau divided by 4 T into rho T. I have transferred this to this side, so they will come here. So P will be equal to N pi D square into tau divided by 4 into T into rho T plus D. This D sometimes you forget. You should not do it. So 2 into pi into D square, we have taken D as 22 into tau is given as 60 divided by 4 into T is 13 mm. This is 80, yeah? Yes, 80 plus D. D we have got as 22 mm plus D. Now, take your calculator. Take the calculator. 2 into pi into 22 square into 60 divided by 4 divided by 13 divided by 80 equals 43 point something plus 22. This will be 65.86. 65.86 mm. You can leave it like that, or you can make it 65.66 mm. You can take. Then we have to find out the row pitch. Row pitch. Now, if they have said find P max, then there is a formula for P max. If they have said P max, that is maximum pitch. For that, there is a formula C into T plus 41.28 mm. This is maximum pitch. It should not be more than that. Now, the value of C depends upon the type of joint. For lap joint, double riveted lap joint, the value of C is given as 2.62 into T is 13 plus 41.28. Now, this will be, how much will it be? 2.62 into 13 plus 41.28. This will be 75.34. It should not be more than this. It should not be more than this. Suppose we had got here more than that, we should have taken this itself as the pitch. Now it is less than this, so you can take pitch, adopt pitch as, if you want, you can round it up as 66 millimeter. It should not be more than this. It can be less than that. It should not be more than that. So we got that as 66 mm. I have rounded it up as 66 mm. Next, row pitch, that is distance between the rows, PB or PC. Different books give it differently. Different design data and books give it differently. Here it is given as PD. In this book, the row pitch is given as PD, that is distance between rows. For zigzag riveting, it is zigzag riveting, 0.33P pitch plus 0.67D. So 0.33 into 66 plus 0.67 into D, we have taken, I think, as 22 mm, right? So that will be equal to, if it is chain riveting, it will be 2D. Now this will be 0.33 into 66 plus 0.67 into 22. 0.33 into 66 plus 0.67 into 22. That will give me 36.5 mm. That is the row pitch, that is distance between rows. Then margin always will be 1.5D, that is 1.5 into 22, that is 33 mm. 33 mm. Now next, what we have to do is, we have to find out PT, PS and PC. Tearing strength is this much, 45,760 newton. Shearing strength per pitch length is 45,660 newton. PC, this is the formula, so it is 68,640. Now the lowest of these is this one, so because PS is the lowest, least, the joint is likely to fail, due to shearing of rivets. How it is likely to fail will be equal to 4.5, that is PS, that is the lowest of the three, divided by P, that is 66, into T, that is 13, into 10.665, or it is 66.5%. This is the efficiency.